please understand, if you do not have a perfect, complete relationship with your father and mother, your whole life will be hell. Completion with parents is the basic thing you need to do. One of the main reason for my strong, heavy presence is I had a such a healed, complete relationship with my parents. I tell you, when you have a complete relationship, completed relationships, the world and my world is in tune. There is no conflict. When the world and the my world is in tune, you will have a heavy presence. Many times people tell me, when I am outside, I try to fight, hate you, I try to fight with you, I decide I will not listen to you. The moment I come to your presence, I don't know what happens to me. My whole body listens to you, not just me. Means, if you are a healed personality, if you are integrated, your body and mind, and you are integrated, then any being comes near you, just listens to that integrity, feels the fulfillment of that integrity. Good. You see, actually, completion is the way to make the whole world good. Now you feel whole world is good. Completion with your parents restores with life itself, understand. That's the most important. Because your experience in all relationships in your life is an extension of the experience you have in the relationship with your father and mother. The source relationship. See, when I was about to leave the house to become a sadhu, I was 17 and half. And one day night, it was a Wednesday, I remember. Just 2 days before, I think Monday night, I had the vision of Sharada Devi and Ramakrishna appearing in front of me. I fell at the feet of Ramakrishna and asked, "Give me sannyas." He said, "She is the one expert in all that. Why don't you ask her?" Sharada Devi, showing Sharada Devi. I fell at her feet and asked her, "Give me sannyas." She put her hand on my head. I immediately know that I am initiated. Both of them disappeared into me, into my body, walked into my body and disappeared. So this darshan has awakened the decision in me to become a sadhu. So Monday this darshan has happened. Wednesday, I am telling my mother, I still remember, and the house, those days the traditional house, on the step, door frame, door step, I am sitting, as usual, this posture only. I was telling, "Mother," I'll tell in Tamil and then translate, "Amma, Samyara Polan Mudi Vanta." I told in Tamil that I have decided to become a Swami, Sadhu. My mother did not tell a single word. Usually she will be afraid to stand in front of me, so she was on the side and she just took the sari end and put it on the mouth, started crying, that's all. Covered her mouth and started crying. And I was just sitting and waiting. For a few minutes I waited. Then I looked and said, "Do you mean I should not go?" In Tamil I asked. "Adha enna povan andringla?" She just shook. No. "I cannot stop, Swami, I know. But I am not able to tolerate, so I am crying." That's all she said. "I cannot stop you, I know. I can't tell that to you, I know. But I am not able to handle, so I am crying." That's all she said. No other conversation. Then I just hugged her. I can see very clearly, before she took her body off, moved, I moved out. I was very close to my mother. Not only in the mind, even physically, I'll always be sitting on her lap. I'll always be sitting in the kitchen, on the table only. Cooking table, pantry is there, that granite slab. I'll sit on that granite slab only and tell her some stories. I used to be very entertaining for her. If I am in the house, I will always be with her only, in the kitchen only. Sitting in the kitchen, talking to her, chatting with her. I learned cooking also from her. Now, because I have, during wandering, I have to cook and eat by myself. Now, so I have learned cooking very close to her. So I just held her, hugged her. I can see very clearly. Before she could feel that hug is complete, or before she moved her body out, she was still crying. I moved out. I tell you, after I realized my incarnationhood, I left 17 and a half. Around 6.5 years, they do not know where I am. And I went to the north, walked, did by wandering, and in the Omkareshwar, I realized my incarnationhood and mission, all that happened. And 2000, I came to south, near Kanchipuram, in a cave, in a place called Acharapakam. Perumbakam is the village. Amapakam. Perumbakam is taluk, Amapakam is the village. It's called Karadi Hills, where they take stones for carving deities. Still now, all the deities all over the world are carved, and the granite deity means the stone is from that hill only. That area, there is a huge quarry. When they quarry, they will leave a small caves, the man-made caves. So I was staying in one cave, and that quarry workers used to give me food. Every day they will give me one meal. I eat that and sleep in that cave. For 9 months I was living like that, to settle down in the body. And when you quarry stone, natural ponds will be created. Artificial ponds means water will stand in that during the rain. That was my taking bath pond to take bath in the place called Karadimalai. Still the place is there. 9 months I lived there. That is the settling period. Once I settled in the body, went to that house where they used to stay. Suddenly they said, long before they sold this house and went away, they are not there in this house. I asked, where are they? They said, no, we don't know. The fellows who are staying there, they all, from the young age, I know them. They all have not even recognized me. Usually, my grandfather, my mother and all will entertain sadhus. Any sadhu comes, they will give food and give money and take care. So they thought, I am also one more sadhu came. I was wearing kavi. And one more sadhu came to eat. And they said, if you want, we will give you food. But that how they vacated the house. I said, no, it's okay. I went away to temple. And in the temple I was sitting, outside the Devi's shrine. And suddenly somebody came and put the food in front of me and said, Swami, eat. And he went away. They went away. I did not bother who it is and I started eating. In few minutes I saw my mother standing. Somebody went and told her, Swami is sitting in the temple, go and meet. She came and she was standing. She is afraid to talk to me. I saw through the side of the eyes and I recognized. She has become fat and her form has changed in the 6.5 years, all that. But I recognized, it's her only. I just looked and smiled at her to give her confidence to come near me. And she came near. She said, Swami should come and eat in the house. I said, now I am a sadhu. If you give Purna Kumbha and receive me with proper way, with all the traditional respect, and do Pada Puja, I will come. She said, yes, she will do everything. And she went and organized everything. And that night I went there. And she received me with all the garland, Purna Kumbha and everything. After eating, I can see very clearly. I hugged her. After eating. This time, I did not move my body till she moved her body. That first hug in which I left uncompleted was completed only with this hug. I tell you, even if you are an incarnation, you have to complete with your mother. You have to complete with your mother. You can't afford having mother having a wound. It was such a strong experience. I felt complete only then. I relaxed. Wow. There was something like a thorn in the flesh got removed. Something was there lacking in my body. Only with that hug, I can say almost 10 minutes I was hugging her. She cried. Maybe this time in joy that she got me back. In joy she cried. Only when she completed and wiped her tears and when she settled down, when she moved her body, I took my hands out. I can say very clearly, I am not the emotional type guy, I tell you. Like a Shiva, dry. But even for me, it was such big completion. Such big completion. And anyhow, after that I never had any, even before I never had any hatred or anything. But it was such a big relief that I healed her. Came back and healed her. After that I continued 2.5 years again my wandering. From till 2003, I continued my wandering. 2003 only I settled down in the this campus. This campus 2003 we settled down. And see, after the Thiruvannamalai visit, after meeting her, again I went away. They don't know where I am. 1.5 years they do not know where I am after that. Then suddenly, somewhere they saw one card, my photograph, and I was staying in the E-road at that time. So they said, oh, now Swami has started ashram, let us go and see him. They came and saw me there. Only then they know that I have started my life with the public. Then of course, after when I started the Sangha here, they came and saw me. When my father passed away, mother came and settled, she is here. But I tell you, unless you complete with your mother, you will not be able to settle in the restful awareness. Because your bio-memory belongs to her. Your biology belongs to her. Please understand, till the age of 3, you are nothing but your father, mother's contribution. At the age of 7, 10% you, 90% they. When you physically become matured, 40% you, 60% they. But till death, 40% of theirs remains in you. You can only be 60% you. You is smart, saying no to your parents, that's all. You always develop your identity by saying no to them. So your no is also in a way extension of their yes. Nothing else. Your no is also nothing but extension of their yes. 40% of you till death remains as your father and mother. The father's portion will be just 10%, mother's will be 30%. So 30% of you still remains as your mother till death. It cannot be removed. It will be there.